I'm Dr. Jeanette Raymond, psychologist, psychotherapist, and relationship expert, here to talk to you about mourning the loss of the child you wished you'd had. And that means the disappointment and heartache about the child that you actually had. I get so many parents telling me, you know, when their kids are growing up, you know, they don't call me, they speak to me with disrespect, they don't answer my calls, they don't respond to my texts, they're rude to me, they're defiant, they don't seem to care about my feelings, they never ask me how I am, they never check in on me when they get older. And there's so much heartache and a sense of being disappointed and deprived and a sense of like missing out on something from these parents that I think it's really important to talk about. So when you're a parent with a very young child, of course you're going to have hopes and dreams and imagine the best for them, and also that they will be the kind of people or person that you would want to have in your life. So for example, many moms talk to me about the fact that, you know, their daughters disrespect them because they don't care about their mother's feelings, about how they dress, about who they see, about the diet that they choose to have later in life, about following family rituals, for example, about going on vacations together, about you know, religion and politics and family laws, L-O-R-E laws, you know, the family traditions and so on. It's very, very painful for moms and dads when your children disregard these very significant values. And as you get older, those values become more important to you. They're part of your identity, and it's only natural that you would want your children to have the same, follow in the same faith and the same value system and the same way of life. You know, think about taking care of themselves, think about taking care of them, you when you grow older, and so on. And so there are lots of dads that I hear, you know, my daughter didn't call me on Father's Day, but I understand she's busy, she's that. Well, but basically it's hurting you. And so what I wanted to talk to you about today is it's natural to feel this way. It's very disappointing and disheartening. But I think it really talks to you. The hurt is because you thought that you had given your children a part of you, that they would want to water it and put sunshine on it and nurture it just as you did when they were little. But once they grow up and they have minds of their own, they get to make their own choices, they live in ways that are different from you, they may mix with people that you wouldn't mix with, and they may not follow the family rituals. There's a sense of loss, a terrible sense that something that was yours once is no longer. You can't control it anymore. You have no you have no influence over it. And it's a very painful and disempowering feeling. So I think it's really, really important to mourn the loss of the child you wished you'd had, which is kind of a mirror image of you for most of the time. You want them to have the same values, same ethics, the same way of treating people, following the same religious rituals, dietary rituals, if you have any, and so on and so forth. And when you realize that your child is not you, that they have different ways, it's like somebody snipped a piece of you off. And you have to mourn that loss of letting go, that you have brought a child into the world. You've given them lots of pieces of you, but they have to now create their own. Out of all the pieces the mom gave you, the dad gave them, grandparents, friends, relatives, schools, you know, media, everything that they take in, they have to create something of their own. And you may not have done it yourself when you were at that age. You may have been more scared and followed along your parents' way of doing things or someone else that was very influential to you. And so you may not be able to understand why your kids are not doing the same thing. So it's natural that you will go through this part. You might feel like a failure. You might feel like you didn't do a good enough job, that if only you had tried hard enough, and you might try even more. Show them the error of their ways, and then they're not mixing with the right people, and how scared you are that they're irresponsible, that they're going to harm themselves in some way, that they're being influenced by the wrong crowds. All very natural things for parents to feel. But unless you kind of come to terms, which is the mourning process, coming to terms, accepting that they are separate from you, they are not you, they don't need to be you, that this is a genuine letting go, and it's letting go for them to have their own life, not to do yours as a do-over. And for those moms in particular, who tell me how sad they are, their sons and daughters don't call them, they don't text, they don't answer their calls, they don't respond. They see what's going on only by looking in Facebook or Instagram. That there's a kind of a distance there, and they're feeling so alone. I would suggest to you as a mom that if that's what you're feeling, then maybe your kids became important to you as things to fill you up emotionally, that they were things that you needed to fill yourself up, and now that they're going out and doing their own thing, you're feeling empty again. And it's not just empty nest syndrome. It's not that you're missing doing their laundry or cleaning their room or making a meal for them or sitting on the couch and watching TV with them. It's that emotionally you were wanting their lives to fill you up, that there was a connection there. And so part of the mourning process for you will be finding other things to fill you up, whether they're social with friends and family, whether they're learning new things online, things you always wanted to do that you never did, whether it's taking up a sport, a hobby, an interest, an extramural activity, whether it's changing your way of life, whether it's volunteering, whether it's taking up a cause, whatever it might be. But you need to fill yourself up with other things than your children's lives. And I guarantee you, when they feel that that is not their function anymore, they'll want to talk to you. They'll want to tell you what's going on. They will be communicating with you in ways that might even feel too much for you. But it's the pressure that they feel to fill you up that makes them stay at a distance and creates this terrible sense of loss and emptiness and despair in you. So mourn the loss of your kids not being there to fill you up anymore, but celebrate the fact that you created these wonderful children who are now going out and doing good things in the world, learning by their mistakes because you can't protect them from everything, just like you did. And that's good. That helps them. That makes them own their mistakes, that they're not yours and you don't have to do anything about it. And see if you can start to fill yourself up with things that are going to last, things that are meaningful to you as an individual. And that will be the healthy mourning process where you accept change and evolution and growth, including for yourself, that you now have a new phase of life, and you will find your kids will want to stay in touch and keep you abreast of what's happening when they don't feel this need that you're pulling them to keep you alive, that they're not bad people just because they don't call you every Sunday or something like that. That's a no-no, and it's going to create problems for you. So take the pressure off them, and most of all, take the pressure off yourself by mourning that loss and filling yourself up with tremendously other good and nourishing things that'll always be there for you. If you have experience of this, I'll be happy to hear your comments. If you stay on this topic, and if you have any questions, I'll do my best to understand them on this topic. See you next time. Bye now.